Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how you can create your screen flows with reactive components. This is something which became GA in winter 24 release. So without any further delay, let's jump to our winter 24 release org and build multiple screen flows with reactive components. So here I am in the Salesforce release documentation. And the first thing that I'll be doing today is building a screen flow with reactive global variables. So for that, let me go to my Salesforce org and go to a custom settings section. So if I go to a custom settings, I have created one custom settings, which is discount percentage. And if I go and see the manage records, now, as you can see in the screen, I have two records. One is system administrator and one other is custom system administrator. For this one, the percentage is 25 and for this one, the percentage is 50. So the use case is if a user logs in with a profile of system administrator, he or she will get 25% discount. If another user logs in with a profile of custom system administrator, he or she will get 50%. So now let's go and see the flow that I have built. So here is the flow. It's a very basic flow, which is having a screen flow and then a screen element where you are asking your user to enter an amount. Then it will show based on your profile, what is the discount percentage? And then final amount is applying the discount percentage. What is the final amount? The important part is discount percentage, how you can dynamically get the discount percentage based on the logged in user's profile, right? So for that, I have created this formula field, which is discount percentage. And if you can see here with GA, if you create a custom settings, you can access the custom settings by using this function. So basically, when you create a custom settings, you need to go to the resource and then under the setup, you will find your custom settings name. So for me, the custom settings name was discount percentage. And that's exactly what I'm seeing, setup discount percentage, and this is the field discount percent. So once you have that field, you can create your final amount, which is basically the entire amount and then some calculation to apply the discount and get the final amount, right? Now I have added this flow in the home page. So this is the home page. Now let me refresh the home page. And this is me who is running the flow. And my profile is system admin. So as per the custom settings, I'm supposed to get only 25% discount. So now I'm on this page, if I put 100, it's showing that my discount percentage is 25. And if I apply 25% on this amount, the final amount is 75. Now, let me go to the user record and I have created one more user. The username is, I believe, James Bond, and the James Bond profile is custom system administrator. So again, as per this custom settings, James Bond should get 50% discount, right? Now I'm going to log in with James Bond, and here is my James Bond. I've logged in as James Bond. If you click here, you'll find I'm logged in as James Bond. But this time, if I put 100, as you can see, the discount percentage is showing as 50, and this 50 is coming from the custom settings. So this is the way how you can create your flow and build reactive formulas within that flow, which will support the global variables. Previously, reactive formulas did not support global variables, and that's exactly what the documentation is telling, that reactive formulas did not support global variables previously, but with this winter 24 release, it will start supporting global variables as you just saw in the previous demo. With that, let's go to the next section, which is basically build screen flows with reactive selections. So for that, let's go and jump to a different example. This is a flow. I've already built the flow, but I'm going to review the flow with you guys. So it's a screen flow again. And first I have done a get all records element, where is basically I'm fetching all the opportunities from the org. And I'm not putting any kind of criteria, basically getting all the opportunities from the org, right? And then I am going to create my first screen. In the first screen, the first element is basically a data table. And in the data table, I'm showing all the opportunities in multiple rows. And I'm telling that you can select only one opportunity from that multiple opportunities, right? So basically multiple selection is not possible, only one selection is possible. Now the use case is whatever opportunity that will select, the same opportunity or the selected opportunity's name and the opportunity stage should be displayed immediately here. So this is a section within the flow, and inside the section I have put two text elements. One is supposed to show the opportunity name and another is supposed to show the opportunity stage. In opportunity name, I have configured the default value as show all opportunities, which is basically this one, this data table, dot first selected row, whatever row that I've selected, dot name. That's the opportunity name will be displayed. Similarly, on the opportunity stage, what I am telling is that show all opportunities, again, from the data table, first selected rows, whatever row that you, or whatever opportunity that you have selected, and the stage name, known as done, save as, and if I do debug, it will show you all the opportunities from the org. As you can see here, currently the opportunity name and the opportunity stage is blank, but the moment you select, for example, this first one, the opportunity name and the corresponding opportunity stage came here. If you choose a different opportunity, it will come here. So what based on your selection, whatever you select here, these two fields will be populated immediately. So basically these two fields are reacting based on what your action on the screen. You don't need to go from one screen to another screen within the same flow. Within the same flow screen, you can make elements reactive, or you can make elements react based on the changes on the other elements within the same screen flow. So this is a really powerful feature. Previously, we need to move from one screen to another screen to make this selection information available. But now you don't need to do that. It's all available within the same screen element. Okay, with that, let's move to the next feature. And if I go to the documentation page again, it's telling now that in the reactive screen, if you're creating formula fields, it can support multiple formulas. For example, substitute, add months, all these things is supported after winter 24 release. Previously, those formulas did not react to changes in elsewhere in the flow until the user navigates to a different screen. Basically, what it's telling, before winter 24 release, to make those formulas take action, you need to move from one screen to another screen, but now you don't need to do that. Within the same screen, these formulas will take action. So let's see that in an example. So here is a flow that I've built. Let's open again screen flow. So what is basically trying to do, it's telling the user that enter the first text. Then it's telling from this first text, you want to substitute any word with which word. So basically it's a substitute function, and final result will come here. So let's do that. Let's debug and see. So if I, in the here, hello world, you can see the final product is hello world. But let's say I want to replace world with my name. And as you can see, the moment I'm typing, it's actually taking action and replacing the word world with Sudipta Dev and making the final product. Previously, you need to jump between multiple screens from one screen to another screen to take that substitute function work. But right now you can do this internally within the same screen flow. So let's go back to the flow again. And basically this final result is basically a formula field. Now, if I open my formula field, which is final result, it is basically substitute, enter first text, substitute with. So first text, substitute with this keyword, whatever value is within the width. And it's a substitute function which takes care within the same screen flow. Similarly, let's take one more example. Here, you need to put the entire amount in USD. And let's say the conversion rate from USD to Canadian dollar is 1.42. So whatever amount you'll put in USD, the corresponding Canadian dollar amount will shown here. And again, it's a very basic formula field. So USD multiplied by the conversion factor. And if I debug the flow again, so if I put 100 here, immediately the conversion takes care. and then 100 multiplied by 1.42 and 142 Canadian dollar. So it's a formula field which is taking action right within the same screen element. You don't need to move between multiple elements, and that's exactly what the documentation says, that you can now take action within the same screen component. So let's talk about the next feature, which is basically reactive components update the first time a screen loads. And as you can see, example wise, it's telling that if you set the default values for two fields and use a formula to add those two values in the third field, the formula calculates the third field when the screen loads. So let's see that in an example. So here is by flow. I have created two number fields. One is number one, enter number one, enter number two. And this is basically addition of number one and number two, very basic use case. But the important factor here is that in the first number field, I have put a default number, which is basically a variable. In number two, I have put a default number two. And here I have created a formula field. So now if I open that, my default number is basically 10. My default number 2 is basically 20, and the add, which is basically a formula, which is basically enter number 1 and number 2. But enter number 1, the default value is default number 1. And enter number 2, that we already have a default value as number 2. Now, when the screen will load, it will always take the default values. You'll always find 10 and you'll always find 20 by default when the first time the screen loads. But the important factor is that this formula field will also work with the default values for the first time when the screen loads. So let's see an example. Let's debug the flow. And you can see this 10 and 20 came, but at the same time, this formula field actually updates and does the addition, like 10 plus 20 is 30. Now you can always make the change. You can always make changes in this one, but what is important is like the first time when it will load, it will always take the default value, and the formula field will also work with the default values. That's what the documentation says in here. The reactive component update the first time a screen loads. So these are the main features, main reactive component features that came up along with Winter 24 release. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share, please hit the like icon, and please subscribe to my channel so that you can get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.